All right, I'm really excited about this next demo. I'm going to talk to you about cards. And it doesn't sound that exciting, but trust me, it's pretty cool. So we've got three types of cards that you'll find in here. Single row or regular card, looks like a 1-2-3 icon, a multi-row card, and my personal favorite, the KPI card. So these are all great ways to draw a lot of attention to very big or very important numbers, or KPIs, key performance indicators. And let's start with our basic card. And it's a very simple object, requires one field input. Okay, so let's go into sales. And if our focus right now is on revenue, let's go ahead and bring revenue into the fields box. And there you go. You have literally just created a card. That's it. One step and you're done. There aren't even really many formatting options for cards as well. You can give it a little background, change the font. But for all intents and purposes, that's it as far as cards are concerned. Now, instead of deleting this and adding a new visual, with the card selected, I can change the visual type to a multi-row card. And it changes the format, the look and feel a little bit. And more importantly, it now allows me to drag in additional fields, like total orders, for instance, and kind of show them side by side. If you resize, they'll stack differently. So again, it's a nice way to just literally draw attention to individual numbers in your report. So cards and multi-row cards are fine, and we'll use them in a couple different cases. But in this lecture, I really want to focus on KPIs. So we're going to insert this KPI. It's got the up green arrow and the down red arrow. And this is not only going to allow us to show a big important number, but it's also going to integrate elements of trending and of positive or negative performance all within the same view in a really nice, clean, visual way. So let me show you what I mean by that. We're going to focus on revenue as a key number here. So I'm going to take total revenue. I'm going to drag it into this field that says indicator. Okay. And it doesn't do anything just yet because the KPI card needs some more inputs. In fact, it says right here, it needs a value and a trend axis. So what does that mean by trend axis? Well, it means that you care about total revenue, but instead of just showing the overall total revenue number, in which case you'd use a regular card, what time period are we interested in? At what level do we want to show the trending performance? And what current period do we want to be reflected in this card? So we're going to need a date-related field. Let's drill into our calendar. And this will just determine the level of granularity that we want to show revenue trending within the card. Now, I think month is probably a good level. It's not too granular, it's not too broad. So I'm going to take start of month and drop it into the trend axis. And check that out. Without even doing anything else, it's already given me a really insightful view here, showing that revenue trend in the background over time, month by month, as well as the current month revenue total, big and bold right in the center of the card. So remember, that trend axis not only determined that trending area in the background, it also determined what time period this number reflects. And since we're trending at the monthly level, this revenue shows current month. And to validate that, we can actually insert a matrix just for a little QA. I actually find myself doing this kind of thing quite a bit. And we can pull in total revenue to the values and that same start of month into our rows. And remember how it kind of automatically creates that hierarchy. Just want start of month. And there you go. So you can see that the latest month drove $1.8 million of revenue, which is reflected here. So far so good, but you'll notice that the KPI card takes one more field. It's optional, but it takes it. It's called the target goals field. And what this will do is add one more layer of insight here and indicate whether this 1.83 million monthly revenue figure is good or bad. And how we define good or bad is a function of whatever we use for the target goal. Now, there are two options that I can think of off the top of my head that would be valid choices for a target goal. Number one is our revenue target that we actually defined. And if you recall, looking at the DAX, it's our previous month times 1.1, basically a 10% lift over previous month. Now we're going to be using these targets for both orders and revenues on the product specific page a little bit later on. So I'm going to hold off on that one for now. And in this case, for this KPI card, what I'm going to use as my target goal is just the previous month's revenue. So when we drag it in and drop it into target, we get that nice little check mark. It all formats to a nice green, and it also shows me the value of that target goal, which is previous month revenue, 1.77 million, which again, we can confirm and validate here in our little matrix view. So that's a KPI card. Fantastic way to draw a lot of attention to the most important numbers for your business. And since AdventureWorks is very much interested in their revenue, in their order volume, and in their returns, I think it would make sense for us to create cards to capture those three KPIs. So no need to reinvent the wheel. Let's copy this one, paste another version down here. And instead of revenue, we're going to basically go through the same process for total orders. So swap in orders instead of revenue. Instead of the target goal being previous month revenue, we want previous month orders. And there you go. We can also pull orders into our matrix to help QA that field as well. Total orders. Okay, so current month total orders, 2146, which is correct. And it's just barely down, less than 1% compared to last month, 2165. So essentially flat, but a little bit down month over month here. So now one more, we're gonna copy the order one, paste it one more time. And this time I wanna show a KPI card for returns. So you know the drill at this point. We're gonna go into our returns table this time, grab our total returns, swap them in for total orders, get rid of the order target, and pull in previous month returns. Now wait, we got fewer returns and it's formatting red as if that's a bad thing. And the fact is fewer returns is good. We want to see a drop in returns month over month. So no fear, there's actually a very easy way to change that. And that's to go right into our formatting options, color coding, direction. See how it says high is good? Just change it right to low is good. And now if it's a drop month over month, that's a good trend. So there you go. Now we've got KPI cards for revenue, for orders, for returns. We can go ahead and get rid of our matrix here. And last thing, probably should have done this first, but let's go ahead and just change the titles here. Instead of this wordy total revenue and previous month revenue, let's just call this monthly revenue. Let's name this one monthly orders, and finally monthly returns. And the final step is just to arrange things in a way that looks nice. I think in this case, I'm gonna try to create some room here, and I really want to focus on revenue as the number one most important KPI. So I want this one to be kind of larger. And then maybe we put orders up here in the top right and returns in here. I'm obviously squishing things in because we've got more visuals that we'll be adding shortly. And again, you can kind of adjust this as you see fit. But for now, I think something like this will do just fine. So there you go. We've created this pretty simple yet pretty impactful way to show the most important business metrics for AdventureWorks: revenue, returns, and orders. So there you go. Great demo of how to use KPI cards with goals to draw attention to the most important metrics for the business.